What is living below in your means? What are the 5 ways to get there? If you are interested in this topic, please stick till the end. Hello everyone, welcome back to another episode of Save Like a Pro with Leah. How is everyone doing? Here in Chicagoland area, we have a beautiful spring day. So at least it's sunny and everything, so it's nice day to stay outside. If you are one of the new subscribers, welcome to the family. Hopefully we will be able to learn some new money saving ideas together. If you are one of my faithful subscribers, I thank you so much for your continuous support. Today I'm going to talk about what is living below your means. What are the 5 steps to get there? What is living below in your means is the money you are spending every month is less than or equal to the money you are bringing. I'm giving you 5 tips to live below your means so you can be more financially independent and you have a peace of mind that you are not owing much debt. Without further ado, let's get into the 5 tips. The first tip I can give you is avoid expensive car payment. Some people try to keep up with the Jones in their neighborhood, which means they may not have any good bank account or other source of income, but they try to impress the community. When you cannot feed your home, why should you try to impress a community? You have to be happy yourself first. Do not try to compete with the Jones in your neighborhood. Some people think about it's a class. If you don't have expensive stuff, you cannot impress people, which is not true. Not happy within yourself. How can you impress others with the fake stuff? First tip I'm gonna give you is avoid the expensive car payment. Some people they might have only less than $100 in their bank account, but they are trying to have an expensive car which you have to pay maybe $500 or more car payment. For me, $500 is half of my rent, half of the expense for my home. When you don't have money, try not to have an expensive car. As long as you have a running car, it's working. Try to use the car till it has a major problem or it stops. My car is 7 years old. It has 130,000 miles on it, but I'm trying to keep it till it completely stops. Second tip I can give you is avoid eating out. When you eat out frequently, it costs you a lot of money. For example, we are family of 4. If we try to eat out, like every week or, 2-3 times a week, that will cost us at least minimum of $100. Plus, you have to pay 20% of tip. The cost is going to add up. Plus, when you eat out frequently, it's not a healthy food. When you are making food at home, it's more healthier and cost you only fraction of the cost. And the third tip I can give you is avoid the expensive grocery shopping. Groceries are one of the major expenses in any household. Try to avoid the expensive stores like Whole Foods, Jewel, Mariano's, Meijer's, those type of thing. Alternatively, try to go to Aldi. Aldi is a German store, pretty much is located in any neighborhood. If you are not familiar with the Aldi, all you have to do is go to aldi.com or download the app. Then look at the store locator. Any neighborhood, there would be an Aldi. Even if there is no Aldi in your neighborhood, maybe 1 or 2 miles away, there is an Aldi. There is Aldi all over United States. It's been expanding, especially last decade. And Aldi has, you don't need to use any coupon, you don't need any, you don't need to look at the sale price. Aldi has pretty much the same price all year long. And if you are an organic shopper, they have some organic aisle too. They have some healthier version. Whichever way you wanna go, you can get more for your buck. So link in the description. Link my video description below. So with the Aldi grocery shopping, you can save a lot of money. To shop at the expensive grocery stores too. What I do is I have an app called Flip. It has all the stores in my neighborhood. So I look at the app every week. As soon as a sale hits, I look at the items I needed. If something is really affordable and I cannot get it at Aldi, I go to those stores. I don't go anywhere else. I just go to the store, and that particular sale item, I try to stack up on the item, so I don't have to go there all the time. When it's on sale, I try to stack up the item. It saves me some gas, so I don't have to go to the place. Plus, it saves me money with the sale deals. So definitely check out Aldi, and I can guarantee you that you wouldn't disappoint it. The fourth tip I'm going to give you is avoid expensive housing. Try not to compete with the Jones in your neighborhood. Buy only what you can afford. Look at how much money you are bringing in. When you buy an expensive house, you have to consider the expensive mortgage. Expensive property tax. Property tax is not gonna go down. Every year it's gonna go up, especially with the neighborhood. Expensive utility bills. Keep in mind that any expensive maintenance repair, come with that. I know we all like to have a nice home and nice things, but try to have a house which you can afford the property tax, mortgage, utility bill, and everything else. You don't have to compete with the Johns in your neighborhood. You just need to impress yourself. As long as you are not in a lot of debt, you can sleep peacefully. Take it from my word. The fifth and the last but least tip I can give you is setting up an emergency fund is very important. You can use the emergency fund for anything emergency comes on the way, like a car breakdown, missing a job or a job loss, or anything else, or a costly house repair you have not planned. So I would recommend everyone to have an emergency fund set up. If you are renting a home, I would recommend you to have an emergency fund set up for at least 6 months. So if something happened, your job or car breakdown or costly repair in the house, you have something to hold on to it. So you don't have to worry about. So something you can depend on it. So try to have at least 6 months worth of emergency fund. In the meantime, you are finding another job or looking for extra money. Try to find some side hustles. YouTube can be definitely one of them, but it takes many years to see any income. Or you can do writing, do some surveys and other stuff. Definitely keep in mind that try to set up an emergency fund for a rainy days. That's gonna help you in the long run. I've been living in this country for last 22 years. I've seen some of my friends and coworkers, they are living by paycheck to paycheck. I feel really bad for them, and some of them I helped over the years, and I told them what to do. Always try to live below your means, or within your means. Don't try to exceed the payment. Do not try to live by paycheck to paycheck. You always have to have some money saved up and try to buy only what you can afford it. So I would like to hear from you guys and let me know how you guys, live below your means. Thank you so much. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please don't forget to subscribe, comment, share and like it. Thank you and have a great day.